Many of us are on the crossroad, not knowing where to go and what path to walk. Many are at the brink of indecisions and letting their life drip in history. I want to encourage you with this conversation between God and Ezekiel in Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 7. God said to Ezekiel this question, and I quote, "Can these bones live?" And Ezekiel said, "O Lord, you are the one who knows." Good morning, welcome to the Words of Hope. I'm Art Velasquez saying, God bless you as we face this new year 2021. I hope to encourage you today, and if you please subscribe to my channel so that you may access all the videos that may be well be an encouragement for you. Thank you. If we were to be asked the same question that was asked to Ezekiel, we probably say the same answer, and worse, we would give an answer that is self-serving, fancy or devoid of understanding, answers that are irrelevant, counterproductive, answers that can astound the mighty God who knew all things. God brought Ezekiel to the Valley of Bones to let him see the condition of Israel, God's chosen people. He was shown them their condition so that he can prophesy them God's plan and God's will. In Ezekiel chapter 37 verses 11 to 14 it says, "Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, our bones are dried and our hope is lost. We are cut off for our parts. Therefore, prophesy and say unto them, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold, O my people, I will open your graves and cause you to come up out of your graves and bring you into the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am the Lord when I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up out of your graves. And I shall put my spirit in you, and you shall live, and I shall place you in your own land. Then shall you know that I, the Lord, have spoken it and performed it, saith the Lord." Three things are evident for Israel's condition. According to the scripture, they say our bones are dried, meaning no signs of life, only death is evident, no light, but only darkness, no joy, only grief, no improvements, but only despair. Secondarily, they say our hope is lost, meaning that they were only drifting in life, no hope, no meaning, no direction, no hope means a gloomy future, no hope means destined to disgrace, destined to the calamity, destined to more troubles and mischief. Thirdly, they say, we are cut off for our parts, meaning they accept their destruction, they accept their condemned future, they accept that they are losers, so to speak. But God says two things for Israel. God says, "Behold, O my people, I will open your graves and I will cause you to come up out of your graves," meaning that their condition is not their destiny. Grave cannot hold them up because God will bring them up. They are not destined to die, but to live. Their destiny is not death, but life. They are not destined to rot, but destined to rise up above their graves. Secondarily, God said, "I will bring you into the land of Israel," meaning that Israel is not destined for exile, but destined to the promised land. Yes, they were exiled just to learn to love their promised land, exiled so that they may treasure God's provision, exiled so that they may be broken and learn that brokenness brings them even closer to their God. When we see these words of God to Israel and the question of God to Ezekiel, we could probably be amazed at what God is seeing in us coming out of 2020 and drifting our life to 2021. You will notice that God is asking us the same question. We are the Ezekiel and God is asking us the question, "Can these bones live?" The bones here, beloved listeners, is your life, your dreams. God saw us. He knew what we are going through. He knew how broken, discouraged, and how devastated we are. But He is asking us if we could make these bones, this life, these dreams of us to live. We just need to answer Him, "God, you knew it, and it will." Just like the Israelites, we sometimes say we are doomed, we are loser, we messed, and sometimes we feel beyond repair. As if we are in the graves, we lose all hope and we lose the will to live. But we knew deep in our hearts that God never leaves us nor forsake us. The life that we live is not our own, but we live it for Him. We are broken, and this brokenness should have led us to Him. And God is saying, prophesy to the bones, speak life to the bones, speak life to your own lives, speak life to your dreams, speak life, speak hope to your soul. We are now entering 2021 and we should start speaking to the year that is coming. Speak life to your lives, speak life to your dreams, speak life to your family, speak life to 2021. The Bible says that death and life are in the power of the tongue. And it is also says that we have to choose life over death. When God created the world in Genesis chapter 1, the first word He said was, let there be light, and the Bible says, and there was light. Light. Speak for 2021 before it manifests itself. Speak light, speak life, speak success, and speak every good things you wanted to see. And lastly, be it known to you, my beloved listeners, you are not destined for the grave. You are destined for glory. That is not your destination. It is life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. You are not destined to stop and settle because your life on earth is a pilgrimage. And everybody, and an everyday journey to the very heart of God. Rise up from the grave, from ashes, for you are destined for greatness. 2020 might be a little rough and blurry, but 2021 is greater by far. God is already here in 2021, even before we arrive, and He is guiding us to greater territory, a great exploit for His glory. God bless you as we have finished 2020 strong. We will even be stronger this 2021. May God bless you. May God be with you. God bless you all. Shalom.